We're here for day four of the 48-hour Camaro build, live at Barrett Jackson in Scottsdale, Arizona. And we've had a lot going on today. I mean, a lot. We've got up front the air conditioning still going in under the hood, a bunch of air conditioning going inside the cabin as well. As Rick Love and Ryan, they get this all put together from Vintage Air. It's a really neat system. It's really trick the way that it goes together. And these guys are making it look super simple as they put all of the components in. We're gonna change a couple of things on the original interior of this car, including taking this non-air conditioned car and changing the vents over to AC vents, which are slightly different, and hooking it up to that SureFit Vintage Air system. Up front, we also have Jeff, who's been doing a bunch of wiring and doing a great job. He makes it look so easy, which it is. It's got painless wiring in it, and that makes it a really simple process. But some of the big hardware that went in today and is really exciting is the Track One suspension from RideTech that's in the rear. Now, we haven't started on the front yet, but in the rear, it's got a four-link setup that actually goes through the floor and the bulkhead area in the back of the car to this really trick, bitchin' bridge bracket system that's at the back of the transmission tunnel. And it's really, really cool the way that this thing goes together, but it's really simple. You just drill some holes and bolt it in. Of course, hanging from that four link is a Curry 9-inch rear end that's got this Miller built full floater setup that is really, really simple. Really, really cool because it uses C7 Corvette hubs for ultra durability, easy replacement, etc. And of course, we can't forget that there are big bare brakes that are gonna get bolted to the back of this as well with an integrated emergency brake or parking brake, as you, if you will. So a lot of neat stuff that's still to come, but today we got a lot done with big suspension, a lot of air conditioning, more wiring, and we're getting close. Honestly, this thing should have brakes on it tomorrow, more front suspension going on tomorrow, and then wheels and tires. I mean, these forge lines and BFGs are gonna look great on it, but I can't wait to make some noise. Remember, this sucker is going to run and drive on Friday. That's the goal. So stay tuned, we got a lot more coming tomorrow here at the 48-hour build live at Barrett Jackson in Scottsdale.